Of all the crops that we grow here at the patch, asparagus would have to be one of the more popular. And you can see why. It's a very versatile plant. You can eat it cooked. I love it raw. It's good in a soup. You can even have it on its own with a bit of butter on it. Now, the parts of the plant we eat are the new shoots that pop up in spring. But now that it's autumn, it's a good time to maintain your plant, give your bed a bit of love, and even pop a few plants in. I put these in as crowns about 3 years ago, so come the spring, we'll be harvesting from them fully. Now, over the summer, they send up this ferny growth, and over the autumn, it turns yellow and starts to die back. So now is a perfect time to get your secateurs out and cut them all the way to the ground. Well, they're all cleared up. Now on to the most important job when growing asparagus. Weeding. Now, if you're hand weeding, that's great. Or you can use a tool like this stirrup hoe here. But the rule is, be gentle. They're a subterranean plant, and you don't want to be damaging the crown. Mulch will help to suppress any future weed strike, as well as trapping a lot of moisture in the ground, especially during dry periods. I'm using this straw mulch in full biscuits for the pathways. And for the top of the beds, I'm gonna use compost. The straw helps to suppress the weeds and also makes a lovely soft path to walk on. Whereas the compost not only protects the ground, it also feeds it, which in turn feeds your plants. A bit of dirt's been freed up in the end of this bed, so I'm gonna plonk in some cheeky asparagus seedlings. Seedlings are what you plant in autumn. As the winter sets in, you can find and put in crowns. Asparagus can also be grown from seed, which is cheap, but can be problematic. You see, asparagus is dioecious, meaning you get male and female plants. The males produce good amounts of spears, where the females, although still producing spears, spend a lot of their energy producing little red berries. So if you plant from seed, you're never really sure what you're gonna get. Now, you may have noticed that I've planted the asparagus in these raised mounds. That's because it requires good drainage. Now, they're a long-term crop. You can keep them like a pet. And although they can take 3 years before you get a good crop off them, if you treat them right, I guarantee you, they'll be feeding you and yours for 30 years to come.